Hey, good morning, YouTube. Just had this box show up from the post office today. I've been waiting for this for a while. Yeah, here we go. So what I picked up was a batch of, this is 50 of these 18650 cell holders. So these are 4-cell holders. I guess they're set up for printed circuit board installation. But anyway, this is for my DIY power wall or lithium battery bank project. So my ultimate batteries will be built in these housings here. So these are some 3D printed battery holders, and they're set up to hold 10 pair of 18650 cells, and then you have a top piece that goes on there, and then you run your conductors down here through the middle. But that's quite a bit of work by the time you put everything in here. And then if you find out, even after you've tested all these cells, if you find out one or two of them just don't stand up to a couple of cycles of charging and discharging, or maybe the capacity doesn't check out right, the pack isn't balanced with the other ones, it's a lot of work, because you've got to cut 10 fuse wires here, and then you've got to cut the jumper wires on the bottom, take it apart, change your one cell, and then you've got to solder jumper wires on the bottom, 10 on the top. Makes a lot of work. So I took an idea from Paul Kennett, and he has what he calls his power shelf. Now he's building 24P battery packs with 12 pairs of cells, very similar to this, put into cell holders like this. You can swap batteries around, you can pull a battery out to test it. And so what I was thinking is, I would use his idea of this power shelf, and I'm going to build myself a battery pack using these cell holders to simulate my permanent setup. And what I'll do is I'll put 10 pair of cells in here. I'll wire these up. I've got some nickel strips. Probably use that. Run a nickel strip down here. So I'll make a four series pack, at least initially. I'll only use 10 out of the 12 positions, but it's cheaper to get the 4-cell holders than buying some 2-cells. So, but what I'll do is I'll have 4 sets of 3 holders, and then I can populate 10 of these positions with my cells, put that in my system, hook it up to my solar charge controller, and then run this pack for maybe a week or 2 weeks, just to make sure that the cells that I put in there are good ones. I've taken these out of the laptop batteries, I've charged them up, I've let them sit for a while, I've done a discharge test, and then recharged them, and then let them sit for a while, but they've really only been cycled one time. And what if one of these cells only lasts 10 cycles before it gives up the ghost? I mean, these are dead laptop batteries. Now, some of these, you know, have tested out pretty well. This one's tested out, this pair, 4241 milliamp hours. So I need 40 pairs or 80 batteries so I can populate one of these with 80 cells, hook it up to my system, and see how it works. And after maybe a week or two, if it looks okay, I'll take the cells out of here, move them into a permanent pack, put the top on, solder all the wires, and then I'll take my next batch of 80 cells, populate the 4 sets of cell holders, repeat the test, and that way I've kind of have a staging area for batteries, because I want to be able to build these things over time, and I want to have these finished packs be fairly well matched to each other. So if I were only building, for instance, 4 of these today, I could take the 4 of these, get them perfectly balanced, and call it done. But I want to build four more of these maybe next month, and four more of these the month after that, and I want the one I build today to be balanced or matched with the one I build 2 or 3 months from now. But I think I want to go run the tabbing down the middle here, have the jumper wires, I'll do all the soldering upside down, and then I can always flip the whole assembly over and then screw it down to, say, a sheet of plywood, and then I'll have my four packs. So there'll be four packs like this with a little gap between them. And then if I need to, you know, I'll leave room. So if I want to add a BMS board, I can maybe leave some space at the top for a BMS. I'll have a balance connector that I can either hook up to the BMS board, or I can hook up to the LiPo battery charger. So yeah, I think I'll probably build like two of these. Maybe I'll build one with a BMS and I'll build one without a BMS. And that way I can put both of them in the system and run them side by side with the same charging, same discharging, and see how they stand up. So yeah, I'll show you how I come up with once I get a chance to play with these. And be sure to check out Paul Kennett's channel. He's got a lot of good information, and I hope to be able to use what he's doing and take his idea and make this into a test rig for building batteries. You can make a perfect sort on a set of batteries I have today, but what's to say that next year, if I decide to build some more of these, how am I going to get the exact same sorted group of cells next year that I did this year? So the idea is I want to be able to build these things to a capacity. What some people are doing is take my best 140 cells, put those in 7 equally sorted groups, and what you get is what you get. But then the next set of 140 cells might sort out to a different capacity. So I want to try to build these to a pretty similar capacity one after another, and so I'll use some of the high cells, some of the low cells, mix those in, and try to see how that works. It may or may not work. That's an experiment, so I'll keep you posted how this is working. And yeah, if you have any comments or suggestions, go ahead and post up in the comment section below. And as always, thanks for watching.